Oh hi, you seem to enjoy those videos that are about OBS and StreamerBot and how you can trigger some cool effects using channel points. So today we have another one and it looks like this. So now you're here, you're talking to chat and someone redeems the mirror effect. Breaks. Perfect. So by the end of this video, you will learn how to do this exact effect using OBS Studio, the Move Transition plugin for OBS Studio, and then StreamerBot in order to trigger it for channel points. So a quick message from our sponsor and then we can begin. Actually, it's sponsored by Own Pro. And if you don't know what Own Pro is, it's basically a service that gives you everything you need as a live streamer to begin your journey. Own is already known for having the biggest overlay library on the internet. So you get access to over 600 of those and they are available in multiple languages. You install full overlay packs in one click. You get your own chatbot that will not only help you moderate, but it will also tell you when you have new alerts. So with Own Pro, you get access to overlays, alerts, a chatbot, widgets, your own donation page, copyright-free music, extensions, analytics, and Own Pro is free to use. But if you want to unlock more features, look at that. You can get 50% off the premium version with the code New Year. So go check it out over at own.gg/gallevelpro. That is own3d.gg/gallevelpro. All right, so the first thing I needed was different masks that I could apply to different cameras so I can have this mirror shattering effect. So I went into photopea.com and I basically created different parts. If you bring them all together, they create kind of a full image. And from there, exported them one by one. Now, if you're wondering how I did that, it's just by creating a new widescreen and then using the pen tool, pressing P, I just created a path. Boom, close that path, create selection. And from there, what I can do is Control Shift J, and that will separate that path from our previous shape, just like that. It also separates it, puts it on a new layer, and you can export that. And you just do the same thing on that main layer, like this, remove the old path, just go around, and repeat, Control Shift J, and you will see what it created. I already did that, I already exported, so the whole thing is to export one by one, going to File, Export As, PNG, and putting them in a folder. You will see I already have my five parts in its own folder. All right, don't worry. There will be a link in the description with all those images that you can download for free. And the second part is the OBS Studio setup. And as usual, what we're going to do is create a brand new scene just to put our camera in. So we want our camera to be full screen and its own scene. So click on the little plus, call it camera scene, click OK, and then you want to go ahead and add your camera as a source. Video capture device. In my case, it's called HDMI. And there it is. And then we're gonna create another scene for our effect. We can call it mirror effects. And now we can add the scene that has our camera as a source. So go to plus, click scene, and click camera scene. Now, what I want to do is go ahead and right click on that camera scene and click on group selected items. We're gonna put each camera in a group. We're gonna call this one one, or whatever you want to call it. And now we can right click on the group, copy, then right click anywhere and paste duplicate. You really want it to be a duplicate. It will create a separate group, basically. You can do this until you have five of them. Nice. And to avoid confusion, I'm going to rename those. Nice. I'm going to turn them off just for now. And we're going to add a filter to that first group. We're going to select the group here. And then we can click on filter right here, or you can also right click and click filters. And we're going to find image mask blend right there. Click OK and click on browse. From there, it's group one. We can find our first shard. There you go. And that's pretty much like the effect that you're going to have on each of them. Let's just do that for all of them. You can either right click all the time, add filters, image mask blend, go find the corresponding one, or you can right click on one and there should be copy filters right here. Of course, it's going to add the exact same image mask, but you can at least change one thing every time. So right click, paste filters, right click, paste filters, right click. Now go on to two, click on filters and find the second image. Boom, close. Three, find the third image. Double click, close. Four, filters, browse. Four, close. Five, click, filters, browse. Fifth image, close. Turn them all on. And you should have your little thingy there. Now, if you really want to have that little speck in the middle, if we're going to add this scene to another scene, basically when it triggers, you can add a black color source, click plus, find color source, click OK, and select the right color. In our case, we want black or whatever color you want. Nice. Nice. Make sure you click and drag it all the way to the bottom so it's underneath everything. There you go. All right. The next part is to set up the move transition filter. This one is kind of special because we're going to add it to the scene itself, not to individual groups. So we're going to right click on the scene. We're going to click on filters and we're going to find move source. Again, this is a plugin. You need to download it. I will put a link in the description showing you how to download, install and use it. Click OK. And here we have our first filter. Now, consider each filter as a movement. For example, this first one, I can apply it to one of the groups and it can be just the regular state, the current position. So what we're going to do is add a bunch of them and then rename them appropriately. We want two movements. We want them to be where they are right now and we want them to, you know, spread out at some point. So we're going to need 10 of them. All right. So I'm going to right click, rename, and this will be 1-0 for group one. Original position. I'm going to right click. I'm going to duplicate it. And this one is going to be 2-0 for group two. Original position. Those look like zeros. Okay, nice. And then we need when they move. So we're going to put 1M. I'm going to right click, duplicate. Right now, they don't have any information, so it's safe to duplicate them, basically. And this is going to be 1M for when group one is moving. All right. If you think the clarity would be better if you had 1-0 and 1M right next to each other, you can always click on the filter and then click on the little arrows to move them. Okay. All right. Now we just need to assign the data for each of them. So one here, we're going to go on source and pick one, right? If you want custom duration, basically how fast you want it to, well, go back to original position, really. Then we can scroll down and click get transform. This is how it records the position, basically. Get transform. Nice. So 2-0, we want 2, and then get transform of the original position. 3 is going to be 3, get transform. You get the point. Nice. We have the original position. So now we're safe to move it around because anytime we press on something else, we can always turn on the effect and it will bring them back. For example, I know that my one is around here. Let me go ahead and move it away. Like, oh no, I moved my one. All I have to do is turn on this filter. And there it is. Why did I make this face? I made this face like you doubted me at some point. Okay. 1M. Is that position that we just did, basically. So 1M, we're going to move it like this. And here, I can click Get Transform. So now, I can play around with moving between 1M, which is when it's moved here, and 1-0. 1M, 1-0. That simple. Do the same thing for the rest. 2, you pick which source you want. You want 2, and you want 2 selected, and you want to move it wherever it is. Where is it? There you go. And then you click get transform. So it records that position. Do the rest. And there you go. This is how it's going to look once everything is basically shattered. And then you can make it go back to the original position. Now, there's one thing that I mentioned in one of my previous videos about the get transform. As you can see, it's not just position. It's also scale and it's also rotation. So if you want them to get bigger and also rotate slightly, you can also input that. You can drag the corners to scale stuff, but you can also right click transform and edit transform and input the rotation before you click get transform, that is. But anyways, we're going to keep it simple here. The goal here is to show you the tools and then you are the content creator after all. Content creator. All right, next step is to go to StreamerBot and actually do the animation with the timing and everything. So here we are in StreamerBot. I'm going to go to actions. Mine is already connected to my Twitch and everything. I'm going to right click. I'm going to click add and I'm going to call this one mirror effect. Nice. If you have groups, you can put them in some groups. Mine is others and just click OK. Nice. Now for you personally, this is the part where you decide, oh, do I want them to all shatter at the same time? Do I want to put some music? How long it's going to last? All that stuff. Now for you personally, this is the part where you decide, oh, do I want them to all shatter at the same time? Do I want them to go one by one and things like that? How long do I want them to stay? I'm just going to make them all go out and then all go back in a couple seconds. So I'm going to right click on sub actions here. We're going to go to OBS. We're going to go to scene because that's where we added that filter. Remember? Well, those filters and then set scene filter state. So it's going to ask you here, hey, which scene, which filter, and do you want it to be visible or hidden? So in our case, it's the right scene. It's the right filter. Visible. Yes. Nice. Now we could do the same thing again and just pick the specific filter that we want, or we can be lazy like me, press Control C and then press Control V and do it 5 times. And this is basically going to be our, hey, turn on the thing to make them move. And in our case, original wouldn't be the one that we want because we want it to start with the original. We want it to move here. So I'm going to double click here and set it to 1M. Click OK. Double click. We want 2M. Double click. 3M. No tape. Double click. 4M. Double click. 5M. No pixel. Nice. Now you decide, hey, how much time you want it to stay shattered. Right click. Go to core, and this is where you're going to find delay. The delay is in milliseconds, so 1,000 is 1 second. In this case, let's keep it 3,000, 3 seconds. Nice. We still have this one saved, so I'm going to control V again, and it doesn't work. I'm going to right click on this previous one, and I'm going to duplicate it. So now I just added another filter state, blah, blah, blah. Double click, and we're going to go to the original. That means that, hey, wait, after you shattered it, and then set it back to the original. That way, we're sure that we're starting with the original position every time. So 1-0, boom, and it's the state is going to be visible, by the way. Duplicate, 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 double click, and then 2-0, 3-0. You know the drill. Nice. And now all we need is to attach it to whatever we want to trigger it. In my case, I kind of like the channel points. So I'm going to go to platform. I'm going to go to channel point rewards. I'm going to right click. Click add, and this is like the actual redeemable channel point thing. So you want this to be as clear as possible. There's the cost, like how many channel points. You can explain the effect here. You can set up the background color if you want. And then of course, there's the cooldowns. Last thing we need to do is go to action and actually set it to the mirror effect that we just created. Boom, select, okay. And we're almost done. We're almost done. We're gonna test it. And then we're gonna add it to our desired scenes. Now let's go back here. And it should be part of my channel points. Look at that mirror effect right there. Click and redeem. It's back. That simple. So if I want to have it in my like just chatting scene, for example, here, I would go ahead and just click plus, add it as a scene, and then pick add existing scene. And in this case, it would be mirror effects. Nice. But we have a problem. The problem is that this is always visible. So we can go back to StreamerBot and basically tell it, hey, maybe turn it off when you're done. And here we have two choices. We can either tell it, hey, that mirror effects source, even if it's a scene, I want you to manually basically do this, turn it on, do the effect, and when it's done, turn it off. Or, which will be easier, when you're done with all of this, turn everything off. Turn this off like that. So first option is kind of easier to set up in StreamerBot, but second option will allow us to add that scene to any other scene with no issues. So right click, go to OBS, go to sources, and then you can click set source visibility state. This is where you make that decision. For the sake of this tutorial, I'm just gonna do that one basically. Oop. I'm gonna do that one. I just turn it on and off before and after the effect is done. So scene, in this case, the one we want is mirror effect. That's the source. And I want it to be visible. I'm going to have to drag it all the way up. It's right there. So I'm going to drag it all the way up. So first thing you do is turn this on and then start moving stuff around. I can copy this and actually duplicate this. I'm going to put it all the way at the bottom so that when it's over, double click, be hidden. So it always starts hidden. Let's test it again. So here, just chatting, blah, 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 mirror effect, redeem, and this happens. Nice. And then it goes back a little fast. Let's try this again. Yeah, a little too fast for me. So we're going to make it wait just a little bit. Let me duplicate this delay. Put it right before it sets everything to hidden. And we're going to make it 100. Now we can test it. So you're here, you're talking, hey, chat, whatever, blah, 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 blah. And then someone redeems mirror effect. Goes back in. Nice. Cuts a little, still cuts a little fast for me. All right, so now you're here. So now you're here, you're talking to chat and someone redeems the mirror effect. Breaks. Perfect, perfect. And it's that simple. The only problem here is that I set it to turn on and off just for that one scene, right? If you wanted to add it to your gaming scene, for example, this wouldn't work because currently it's turning it on and off only in your just chatting scene, because that's what I set it up. So you can set it so that it's it does the same thing just from the other scene, for example. So if I go to capture, that's kind of my gaming scene, quote unquote. Let me turn off the display capture here. And I wanted to add it, right? So I would click plus, I would go to scene, and I would go to mirror effect. By default, it's on, but we would turn it off. And now if I redeem it, it won't work because it doesn't know to turn it on in that scene. So what I could do is Do it for each and every scene. That's why I said, hey, you should probably just do it so that it turns off every source of this mirror effect scene. So you decide. You decide. I'm giving you options, right? Are you lazy on setting it up for the first time? Or are you lazy on setting it up in the future? That's your decision. The animation is pretty crude, so I'll let you basically play around with the delays and also the type of easing to make the animation maybe a little smoother. That is all on you. And there it is. If you have any inspiration for some cool effects that I could do, please leave them in a comment section below. I do intend on making way more of those. If you want to test it and see it in action, you can come over to my Twitch channel. Yes, I stream. Other than that, just subscribe, please. And I will see you all next time. Go out there, make me proud, get level, out.